What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, and today I'm going to try to actually record a vlog. That's right, that's our first vlog. And you know, each vlog has a title, and we decided to go with this question, right? Not really a question, but just a title. Programming languages. Right, this is a free talk about programming languages. And try to limit myself to 10 minutes. Now it's 6:10? 0601, 0610. Now it's like 100. But yeah, so it's like in 10 minutes, we'll try to just discuss about programming languages in general. So the beginning of programming languages, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to go through history. But on a more serious note, programming languages from the age that I learned programming, I noticed there are always two pattern, maybe three more programming languages. There is always the client-side programming languages. There is always server-side programming languages. There have been scripting languages. And there are functional languages that I'm not very experienced with, but it's been used a lot in science, and it's gaining a lot of traction these days. Functional languages, that's the trend now. But in general, I want to talk about client versus server languages. Back in the day, like when we, in the 90s or even before, when we tried to build an application, most of the time, this application is used by yourself, right? It's just used in the same computer. So you write an application and you'll literally just execute that application on the same machine, or you can give it to someone else and they will use it on the same machine. And we've seen a lot of applications like that, right, in the 90s, where we share application, we download like scanners and email applications, and I've written a lot of applications that are single based, like where basically they are client application. They only work on the same machine and they use the CPU. They are CPU intensive on the same machine they are running on, right? So I remember one application is I would actually take a mathematical equation and I will draw a graph out of it, right? So that was using the CPU to draw the graph. And it will basically, it was actually written in VB6. So it will only run on Windows, obviously. That's another thing we want to discuss. Like in general, the programming languages, how do they compile and which operating system? It's actually exciting, right? So client language, a client side language is where basically the Visual Basic, right? The VB, and then VB.NET, and then that wasn't enough, right? Because, well, writing an application that you run for yourself is cool, but we started to need to communicate with remote servers, right, to execute certain things, or maybe to like to connect to using sockets to connect to remote computers to do other things on that remote, like controlling that remote machine to do something on that remote machine. And that was fun for in the late 90s or beginning of the 2000s, where we were an application and we would be the server, right? We were not a server application and a client application. The server will listen. You'll put the server application, the exe, you'll put it running on one machine, and you'll have a list of commands listening a port, listening to a port, and then your client application, which understand how to talk to this server application, you connect to port, say 1234, and you start sending commands that only this application understand. And said, and the always fun command was how to open the CD drive, right? So it will eject the drive. I know it will freak people out when we do that in the university. So we'll install the server application into one machine, and then from another machine, we'll just write a command, literally to send a command, which literally calls the Windows API, which opens the drive. And that was always a fun thing to do, and we'll laugh on it. So server, client. So in this case, we've written an application using the same language effectively, right? Visual Basic, right? VB6 in that case. We've written it on the server, we've written it on the client, right? The server and the client using the same programming language, right? But we kind of created our own protocol, which nobody understood, right? This is just a port that you open, and then you connect to this port, and then you basically do things, right? Lots of application were authored in this manner as well, where you have a client and a server, and up to this date, like, databases work the same way, right? Oracle listen to port 1532, correct me if I'm wrong. Postgres listen is an application, the server running code, listening on this port, and then you connect to this application, and then basically you execute commands that the client, which is in this case the Oracle client, that's why you have Oracle client and Oracle server, they're effectively written in the same language. But yeah, so they are written in the same language, right? Then comes the web, right? Maybe it was there, but I didn't know about the web until later. Web development. What's the first thing that comes to mind? ASP, right? Which is a Microsoft. It's essentially VB6, I think, VB. But it's just like have a slightly different syntax. But you have to execute that on a web server. So there is a well-established protocol. So you can't really listen to your own ports and do fancy things. You can still do a lot of things, but the communication is there. The HTTP protocol is already there, established for you. What does that mean? That means that the client is now has to understand HTTP. This is, oh well, okay, Visual Basic and HTTP. How can I teach Visual Basic to talk to HTTP? It wasn't natural. This protocol, VB, was not designed to talk to HTTP, right? Like, there are obviously other things that come after that. Okay, 2 minutes left, but yeah, in general, just we're gonna wrap up in soon. But yeah, VB did, or other languages, wasn't designed to talk to these languages. To these protocols, right? So they had to invent a language that comes natural to HTTP, right? So that language, right, was JavaScript, right? JavaScript, VBScript also, right? JavaScript and VBScript, like, it came in natural because these are browser-based. The beauty of those, you don't have to compile them. You don't have to have anything. You just have to have literally Notepad, write your code, and then that JavaScript will know how to communicate with the HTTP because it just comes natural, right? Because the browser hosts the JavaScript application. Otherwise, you will have in your VB application or C# or other languages, you'll have to host your own protocol to talk to HTTP, right? And yeah, so PHP, became very popular, really. PHP in the 90s and the early 2000s. I wrote a lot of applications using PHP. PHP was the main server-side language, right? You can't run PHP in the client. I don't know if you can, but you wouldn't run it. So PHP, you write code in PHP, and then if you execute certain, a page will execute in the server, and then will return something to the client to do something with it, right? So again, so PHP in the server, people have written PHP in the server, and then HTML/JavaScript in the client until JavaScript has been made by some genius to run on the server. And then we go back to the same cycle where JavaScript, we have the same language running both on the server and on the client. Guess what? Not only on the server and the client, it runs everywhere. JavaScript runs everywhere, literally on IoT devices, mobile phones. It's a universal language. That's why I really like JavaScript. Python is a great language. Not a big fan. I have my reasons, but yeah, I just prefer JavaScript. Python, I tried to learn it. I still don't know. You might convince me, but I prefer JavaScript. I started Visual Basic. That was my first language I learned. Make all the fun you want. All right. Visual Basic back when I was 15 years old. I don't know the year. I don't want to reveal my age. Right, so yeah, so that Visual Basic, then after that I learned PHP, ASP, PHP, a lot of PHP, JavaScript, obviously HTML just comes naturally with the territory, and I learned, believe it or not, I learned C# just 3 years ago, because I had to, right, because especially when I came to this state, really, because like everybody was using C#, right? So I have to switch to C#. And being from a computer science background, learning new languages is no problem at all. It's just literally you want to build the same application, but with a different programming language. So if you want to learn how to do a certain thing, if you see a piece of code written in any language, you will know if this piece of code is bad or good, in my opinion. You will read as, okay, this code is trying to do a loop inside an open connection. Oh, that's bad. It's a universal, any language, right? Right? It's like laughing in any language. You know that people is laughing, right? Or if someone is making fun of you in a language, you'll know they're making fun of you, right? So it's the same concept of programming languages. Any programming language written, you'll know that you know how to basically learn a language in a very simple manner. All right, I've been babbling a lot. It's been 30 minutes. I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Simple, first vlog. Excuse me if I was going left and right, but I'm gonna see you in the next one. Leave your question. Leave your comments below in the comment section. What is your favorite programming languages? What is your favorite programming languages with an S, right? So, what's your favorite? What is your first language you learned? What is the recently language you just learned? Share and let us know. I'm gonna see you on the next one. Goodbye.